Catiscià. The miscreant who robbed me of my love. But vengeance pursues. They are heating the cauldron.
Catiscià, behold a suppliant at your feet. Catiscià, mercy.
Mercy? Had you mercy on him? See here, you. You have slain my love. He did not love me, but he would have loved me in time. I am an acquired taste. Only the educated palate can appreciate me. I was educating his palate when he left me. Well, he is dead. And where shall I find another? It takes years to train a man to love me. Am I to go through the weary round again and sit the same time in poor mercy for you who robbed me of my prey? I mean my pupil. Just as his education was on the point of completion. Oh, where shall I find another?
Oh. Here.
Here.
What?
Catiscià, for years I have loved you with
a white hot passion that is slowly but surely consuming my very vitals.
Ah, shrink not from me. If there is aught of woman's mercy in your heart, turn not away from a lovesick suppliant whose every fibre thrills at your tiniest touch. True it is that under a poor mask of disgust, I have endeavoured to conceal a passion whose inner fires are broiling the soul within me. But the fire will not be smothered. It defies all attempts at extinction, and breaking forth all the more eagerly for its long restraint, it declares itself in words that will not be weighed, that cannot be schooled, that should not be too severely criticized. Catiscià! I dare not hope for your love. But I will not live without it. Darling!
You, whose hands still reek with the blood of my betrothed, dare to address words of passion to the woman you have so foully wronged.
I do. Accept my love, or I perish on the spot. Oh,
go to. Who knows so well as I that no one ever yet died of a broken heart?
You know not what you say. Listen.
On a tree by a river, a little tom-tit sang willow, tit willow, tit willow. And I said to him, Dickie bird, why do you sit singing willow, tit willow, tit willow? Is it weakness of intellect, birdie-like ride, or a rather tough worm in your little inside? With a shake of his poor little head, he replied, oh, willow, tit willow, tit willow. He slapped at his chest as he sat on that bough, singing willow, tit willow, tit willow. And a cold perspiration bespangled his brow. Oh, willow, tit willow, tit willow. He sobbed and he sighed, and a gurgle he gave. Then he plunged himself into the billowy wave.
willow, tit willow, tit willow.
How I feel just as sure as I'm sure that my name isn't Willow, tit willow, tit willow. That was blighted affection that made him exclaim, oh, willow, tit willow, tit willow. And if you remain callous and obdurate, I shall perish as he did, and you will know why. Though I probably shall not exclaim as I die, oh, willow, tit willow, tit willow.